Hey, you bad buddies. Paul Roberts here. We're going to do something different today. Haven't got a lot of interest in the belts or in the spear gun. I'm going to skip over that. Got a cowl on my table today, and I'm going to show you how I do finishing. So let's go. I've been doing about one or two of these a year. They're just not popular. I think people have, you know, the computer printing now, and a lot of people played the game a long time ago and used different skins, but I'm glad I did it because I had a good time doing it. And every once in a while, I help a bat buddy out. And I'm going to show you what I do to each one of these. Now, I could redo this mold, but all the details are really good. It's just got a few flaws. Like, for instance, it's got this little flaw down here, and every single one has little bumps or little things that I can take off. And this cowl will be perfect when I'm done. Sometimes the tops of the ears don't come out. I had some stuff down in the bottom of that. It's been probably 6 months since I've fooled with this. I guess I didn't clean it out well enough. So this cowl will be perfect. And I'm going to show you a few of the things I do to make sure that happens. So all I need is a pair of scissors. Hey, what's that in your ear? Yeah, that'll do. So the first thing I do, and I'm not going to show every part of this because we'll get it long, and it doesn't need to be long. The first thing I do is, this is just raw latex, and I just trim this. And I made this little thing like this, so it'll go over just about anybody's cape, depending on what kind of cape you have. It'll make it a lot easier to feather into that. Now this, I didn't really build this up very much. This is gonna be a large headed cowl. And so it's a little bit more flexible. And a lot of people like that anyway, because latex is just more comfortable, whatnot. But I can build this up so that it stays straight across like that. It's a lot more heavy here and then lighter up here. But that's if somebody comes to me and asks for those things. Otherwise, I'm just gonna do it standard. So everything I'm showing you today is standard. If you've got one of these, you did well, especially if it was perfect. I've only done a few perfect ones. Here's some things here that I have to work on. Now you say, well, why don't you just redo the mold? Because it takes me a day to do a mold, a whole day practically. And if you only do one a year, it's not worth it. It's easier to fix what's wrong with each one because latex is so workable. So this particular one, I don't even know if I'm ever gonna redo it. Maybe I will, you never know. Things come in phases. Bat buddies might all of a sudden get on a new kick. I doubt it, but. So as you see, this is not oxidized, but it has a little bit of plaster residue on it. I'll be washing this off and I'll be painting it. I'll be making everything look really nice. You don't have to do this with urethane. It's one of the things that takes longer for me and it's inefficient. I'm one of the few people that work with latex. You've heard me talk about these things before. Basically, the first thing I'll do is we'll take this and I'll cut out the mouth. And I always do everything exactly the same way because I get efficient at it. Not that it really matters when you're doing something like once a year. But basically, I'll know I'll be dremeling this later. I know exactly how much I need to make sure that it's gonna go really smoothly and dremel nicely. And I'll cut it the exact same way every single time because that way I'll remember what I did the last time and I'll do it all over again and it'll go smooth for me. Now people that do urethane cowls also do this. But if they cut it nicely, or if they just have the jagged edge hidden on the inside, you can't really dremel urethane. I dremel latex, especially on a finished cowl. This will be nice and smooth, even on the inside when I'm done with it, because this one's going to be finished. So a lot of times when I have something that's damaged, I'll go ahead and paint it up, and I'll make the battle damaged one, and I'll call it an imperfect. And I'm always shooting for a perfect. So I'll go ahead and I'll trim out these eyes, and then I'll show you what I do next. So the first thing I do is I go on the inside after I've cut the eyes out and I cut them again on the inside before I ever do any dremeling. That way I know they're cut as well as they can possibly be before I ever start working on them. Now I've had people that say they want to have larger eye holes. That's doable. And I've even had a few that say they want smaller eye holes. If you're willing to accept that it's not made to be that way, I can even do that. Some people, if you have a really tight cowl, the eyes will bother you. They'll go gouge into your eye sockets. And so I try to make it so they're not very deep on the inside. But if you ever find one that you have that's a little bit deep for you, you can always go and do this on the inside, like I'm doing now, or Dremel it down on the inside and make it so it doesn't stick into your eye socket as much. Everybody's different. But one of the things that latex does is it's so forgiving. You can force it to be the shape of your face a lot more than urethane. So I'll just do a preliminary try on with this, just with the baby powder on the inside. I don't have any KY jelly on me. I'm out currently. Can you believe it? So I just check it out and say, okay, will this fit a 24 inch head? Absolutely it will. Oh, excellent. I'm gonna go check the mirror. Excellent. Look at the room I got in this thing. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna show you the different types of things that I fix on a latex cowl. There's three things. There's things that stick out and I have to Dremel them down. There's things that might have a little bit of area where this one's really good. I'm gonna have a hard time finding problems with this one. Might have a little hole. I'm not even seeing one currently. For that, I'll fill in the hole. And then finally, sometimes the tips aren't perfect and I'll build the tips back up and sculpt them back into shape. Gosh, this cowl's so good. Oh, here's a hole. Here's a hole right there. There, and there, and there. So I will take and fill in those holes. Every time I start a new cowl, I have to get this where it works again. Yep, okay. So I'll take this, nice and clean and ready to go. And I'll simply fill in these holes. Now I'm gonna overfill them just a little bit, okay? Because latex shrinks, and I'm gonna come back when I'm done and smooth these out. So I want a little bit extra. All right, so there you go. And there's just a little tiny ones down here. I'm gonna paint this. These will be really easy to fill in, even with just the painting. I probably don't even have to do them. So I'm gonna go around and do this. But let me show you the other thing first. These days, for something like this that's technical, I'll use this. You can also use this, and this, and this. But because these are so small, and I wanna go right flat, right up against the cowl, I'll take something like this. And I'll say, okay, this is so large. It's actually a chunk missing out of the mold, and I can't fix it because it's on the inside. I can redo the mold, but this is so easy to fix, it's just not worth it. I could fix this 300 times for the time it'll take me to make the mold over again. So right now, since I don't put out very many of these, I just fix them. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this now. All right, so I fixed all the little holes. There are very few of them. Now, I have super glued this Q-tip on here. I'm gonna guess that about that height is how high that ear is gonna be. And I'm gonna go ahead and set this up in there really well. And I'm gonna go ahead and just call this a day. And then when I come in here tomorrow, I can build it up and then start doing the shaving down parts. I could start doing some of the shaving down parts right now if I wanted to, but I don't wanna. Because I'm doing two things at once, it'd be easier for me if I just keep it two separate processes for this video. The ears are going to be built up a little bit more and I'll do it in stages. So that's it for today. So I'll put this away and I'll work on something else on my table. There's just so many people out there offering things now that, well, there's only a few people that like the latex approach or the type of style that I use or whatever. And so I do other things and I'd like to be flexible. So I put this aside and I'm gonna work on some other things. Work on an Indiana Jones gun. And I've got a cape in another portion of the cave. Working on that right now, too. Bat buddies, if there's anything that you need, let me know. And I'll get back to this either on this. I'll probably do a part two for this, if there's any interest. I'm going to start doing that more. If I don't get comments, I just won't produce. For you, I'll still produce. But bat buddies, let me know what you're thinking. Let me know that you want to see these things. And I'll be inspired to do more. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One.